Students. In last few lectures, we have seen the flow charts. We have also seen the different tools that are available for C and C++ programming. Today we are going to use one more tool, which is we call that is a dev tool, which is used for both C and C++ programming. The tool is very simple. It has a notepad like interface, which can be used for a debugging purpose, execution purpose, as well as editor purpose. Let's continue with our C programming. The C programming concept that we have seen in the last few lectures, we have seen the flowcharts, we have seen some algorithms, and now we are going to see the basic concepts about the C programming. Might be you are well aware about the mathematics within your 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th examinations or classes. You have seen that if we want to store a variable, if we want to store a value, we are going to have a variable for that. Variable to store the value. Within the mathematics, we are talking about currently mathematics. We are not talking about C. Variables has the capability of storing the data. That means a variable is a container which stores the data for we people. Now the thing is, when we talk about the variable, now there exist different kinds of the containers, which will contain, one will contain, say for example, one container will be meant for the water. Second container will be meant for the milk, third container will be meant for the oil, is it? So whenever we want to store oil, we will store it in the container oil, or where the label of the oil is being depicted on the container, we will store it there. If we want to store a milk, we will check which kind of the label it is and we are going to store it. Similarly, within the C, we have concept of variables. Variables are those particular things which gives us a provision to store the data in terms of itself. Now, as per the mathematics, we have integer variables, integer data. We have floating point data. We have character data. We have character data, even we have string data as well. It's a combination of the two. Now, when we talk about these, there, in order to categorize these particular things, we say that we have again one more, we call them as array. In order to categorize the first three, these integers, we call them as primary data types. And later on, there might be one more, like union is one of the data type. Union is one of the data type, and there are few etc. Is it? Now, when we talk about these data types, these three, the first three, we call them as a primary data types. Primary means these are the basic data types. And the lateral part, we call them as a derived data types. That means they are being derived by one or another thing from their primary data types. Like strings are derived from the characters, arrays are derived from characters as well as integers as well as floating point. Unions again is a combination of array, string, character, float, integer. That means whenever there will be a derived data types, there will be always introduction of those basic data types. The basic data types here are integer. We say that float and character. These are the three basic data types available within this. And literal strings, arrays, lists, whatever they have, templates, again and so on, they are derived data types. These are sometimes called as the basic data types, and these are called the derived data or advanced data types. Sometimes we call and sometimes we call them as a primary data types, and these call as a secondary data type. Now, what data types actually mean? Let us see. We will talk about the real life. If somebody has a caste of Sayyid or some say Qadri, one has a caste of Zargar, another has a caste of say for example Mir. So we are categorizing that this belongs to the dynasty of say Qadri, this belongs to the dynasty of Zargar, this belongs to the dynasty of Mir. Similarly, if we have some data, we need to check which kind of the particular dynasty it belongs. Whether it belongs to the integer, whether it belongs to the floating point, and whether it belongs to the character. And it is the responsibility of the user to have a knowledge about what kind of the data we are going to use. The first basic data type that are integer. Integer are the basic data type available within the basic data types available within the C, and is capable of storing integer data into the variable where variable are declared as integer. That means before using integer, before using their data, you need to store the data in some variable, and that variable should be of the same data type which our data. For example, you need to store the data 10. Is it? 10 is an integer. So how we are going to store it in C? We say that we are going to use the keyword int for integers. Remember, keyword int is used for integers, and if you are using 32-bit machine, then it will be, the size will be 2 bytes, and if you are using 64-bit machine, size will be 4. That means it depends upon the machine, but the basic definition of the size is that integer will hold 2 bytes of the data, and it will range from 26074 to minus 26074 to plus 26078. This is the range of the integer and size of the integer, and this integer is meant for storing the integer value. The first thing that how we are going to create, or how we are going to declare an integer variable. In order to declare an integer variable, we need to mention the int keyword first. Keyword is used for declaring, these are the reserved words which can be used for one or the other thing in terms of the C. Like int is a reserved keyword, is a reserved word which is used for declaring the integer values. Say we say that int num is a variable here. Num is a variable where we are going to hold the data. Int is an integer. If we are going to write down like this, int num and then semicolon, we say that kindly create a variable by the name of this num. It tells the compiler that kindly create a variable by the name of num, because every particular variable has a name, and this name is the name of the variable which is capable of storing integer type of the data. Say for example, if we are going to write like this, float is float. It says to the compiler that num is a variable which is capable of storing the integer value. We have not stored anything yet, but we tell the compiler previously, or what we can say at the initial level, that what kind of the data we are going to store within this variable. This is mandatory in terms of the C. However, there exists some languages where type casting is not, or type macking is not mandatory. it will automatically cast your variable into itself. But when it comes to the C, we need to mention what kind of the data we are going to store within this. Similarly, if we are going to store a character value, we need to say char c. We tell the compiler that this C is a variable, this C is a variable which is capable of storing a character data type. That means if we need to remember the thing that if we are creating a variable by the name of num, we need to associate the data type with it. That means the data type is very important when we come to the C, C++ programming uses these data types in order to store the data. This is how we can create the variables within your C. Let us see one simple example where we are going to store the data, an integer data. We say that integer num equivalent. These are the two operations. The first operation is like this, and num equivalent to 10. Now we have in the last line we have combined these. If we can write like this, int num equivalent to 10, it is same as that of int num, then semicolon, and num equivalent to 10, then semicolon. These two lines are equivalent to this line. We say that first declare a variable, then initialize. These are the two combined steps. Declare a variable as well as initialize it. But in this line, we declare it first and then initialize. These are the two we can use it interchangeably. Now, this is how we are going to store the data. If we need to print this data, print integer data, we need to use the placeholders. %d is used for printing the value of an integer variable. That means what we need a placeholder. For example, if we have num1 comma num2 and we have two variables, num2 equivalent to 20, is it? And we need to print both %d and %d. This means %d will be the first value, second %d will be the second value. And if I am going to write it like this, comma num2, what it will show me? It will show me 10 and 20. This %d will act as only placeholder for displaying the value of your integer variable. If I am going to execute it, compile, okay, no error, and then run, obviously there are 10 and 20. If I am going to use one more variable, we can use any number of variables, num3 equivalent to 30, okay? And we are going to use like this, and %d, and we are going to use here num3. That means num3. Any number of the values that we are going to use, we are going to print, we need to use those much of %d's. अगर हमें दो integer value print करने हैं तो दो %d use करने. अगर हमें एक ही integer value print करना है तो एक ही %d use करना है. और उसके साथ साथ कौन सा value आपको print करना है वो भी देना है. That means मुझे इस %d के बजाय num का value चाहिए, इस second %d के बजाय num2 का value चाहिए, और third %d के बजाय. It always acts in the sequence. पहला %d पहला value लेगा, second %d second value लेगा, और third %d. Is it? That means hope you got aware about how we are going to store the data, an integer data, how we are going to create an integer variable, rather how we are going to store an integer data in terms of itself, and how we are going to print the data integer of type. Similarly, if we have, say, now we are going to use the float. Float is used for storing the precision values as well. That means decimal, जो आपका fractional value है ना, वो part भी integer में capability है कि वो fractional part को store नहीं कर सकता. But जो float हमारे पास है, float में capability है कि वो fractional part भी store कर सकता. But उसके लिए क्या है? Similarly, it is the basic data size of your float is 4 bytes. Is it? It is 4 bytes. In terms of the C, it was 2 bytes. And within our float, if we are using a float data type with the variables, then the size will be 4 bytes as a standard. And it is the float has a capability of storing the fractional part of the data as well. But in order to print this particular float, we need to have %f sign. Yahan par bhi %f. यहाँ पर भी परसेंट. That means याद रखो कि परसेंट d किसके लिए लगता है? इंटीजर के लिए. और परसेंट f किसके लिए लगता है? ये फ्लोटिंग पॉइंट के लिए लगता है. ठीक है, इफ यू आर गोइंग टू एग्जीक्यूट इट, कंपाइल, नो एरर, रन, ओके, इट इज 10.500, ठीक है, 20.500 एंड 30.500. एज यू कैन सी हियर that within your, you can see here we have mentioned 0.0, 0.5, 0.2. If I am going to use it like this, %d, %d, and %d, it will not show any error. It will not show. However, the fractional part will get truncated. It will not be displayed. Like this, compile, okay, no error. But as we have seen, 0, 0, 0, is it? That means your part will not be displayed as properly. So in order to use it, we have to use it %f, %f, and %. Clear? Now what we are going to use, we have seen two things. First, integer, how to create an integer variable. Second, how to display, how to assign an integer value. Third, how to print the integer value. Similarly, we have taken the concept, the floating point, it has a size double than the integer. That means integer ke agar 2 bytes hai, to iske 4 bytes hai. So it is capable of, integer is not capable of storing the fractional part of the data, while as floating point is capable of storing the fractional part of the data as well. And in order to print the fractional part or floating point values, we have to use the placeholder %f. And for integers, we have to use the placeholder %d. So hope you got an idea about the basic two data types, which are integer and float. In next lecture, we are going to have some few more things about the same. Thank you. Thank you very much.